talk about communication, but it is very strange because I want to communicate with you and I'm talking about communication, so it is a kind of meta-communication, talking about communication. And there are many descriptions about human being. Aristotle claims that we are rational animal, which means Homo sapiens. And John Huizinga, who was a sociologist, claims that human being Homo ludens, which means playing and playing games. There are many descriptions, but I believe that they neglected the communication way of human being. We are storytellers. We produce stories and we listen to stories. And we live according to stories. And also we construct some things according to our stories. For example, this is a table. And inside the table, there is a story. There is a story. What kind of story? In order to produce this stuff, you have to make a labor. You have to make an effort. And also you have to make money in order to produce this stuff. So everything, every material, every stuff, every relations are full of stories. And in the presentation, I would like to touch these kind of topics. First of all, there are many misunderstandings about communication. And many scholars, many people think that communication is a kind of speaking, talking. But communication is much older than this. Now we are in class environment, and you are listening to me. I am trying to make a presentation to you. At the surface level, I am active because I am producing some symbols. And you are listening to me, and you are passive. But this is superficial distinction because you are trying to listen to me. And this listening process means that you are making effort to try to catch the symbols. And you are in an effort to catch the symbols. That means that you are also active in the communication process. That is why communication is an action. Even if you are in silence, it doesn't mean that you are passive. And also we are sleeping, we are daydreaming, we are dreaming. Dreaming and daydreaming also active process. Because we are connected to the world, to the people, to the relations. It is very extremely dynamic process. I am making this presentation and you are trying to catch the symbols. Maybe before the lesson you were thinking in a different way. Maybe after the lesson you will change your minds. I don't know. In positive way or negative way, I don't have any idea. But it means that symbols can make a difference in our life. What I am trying to say is this. So, when we look at the origin of communication, we understand that we can place a keyword, sharing. Because the origin of communication comes from common, which means collaboration. Communication, community is the word also which is related to communication. And when you share some things, we are getting into communication. But some things means symbols. When you share symbols, it means you are getting into the communication process. I want to touch on this issue because many people think that communication transmission of the messages, not transmission of the messages. If you think that communication is equal to transmitting messages, that is a problem because I am producing messages, you are listening to me, so I'm just trying to transmit messages, and you are just passive people. It is not such a thing. It is an ongoing process. It is very interchangeable process. So, and there is another misunderstanding. We think that communication starts with learning language. It is not correct. When we are born in the world, communication starts for us. Because it is active process, our body thinks, we can express ourselves by crying, by doing different activities. So when does the communication finish? When we die. When we die, communication finishes. For any individual, communication means as long as we live in the world, as long as we exist in the world, communication starts with born and finishes when we die. But for the society, communication exists as long as the society exists. So, when we look at the philosophy, Immanuel Kant says that we have some powers, understanding power, imaginative power, taking pain and pleasure power. There are different kinds of powers, and these powers are innate. We are born with this power. According to Noam Chomsky, who is a linguist, we are born with the communication capabilities or learning language capabilities. In the United States, when a student was born, he can speak in English because he lives in English, he or she lives in English, in England. But in Turkey, when any people was born in Turkey, he or she can speak Turkish. But nevertheless, they are able to speak any language. We are born with language capabilities. And there is another misunderstanding about communication, because some people think that when we break up someone, communication finishes. It is not correct. Non-communication is impossible. Non-communication is impossible. Communication doesn't mean that we should get along with others very well. We sometimes have bad relations, but it doesn't mean that communication finishes. We have negative feelings. Maybe we don't have any communication bonds with others, but nevertheless, we think that these people are bad, these people have negative feelings, so I am communicating with others even though we have negative feelings. Non-communication is impossible. So, at this point, I would like to try to explain the communication types. This is analytical separation. It doesn't reflect the reality. Reality is different from the analytical separation. We are just making signs. We are just doing signs. According to me, we can classify four categories communication types: intrapersonal communication, face-to-face communication, mass communication, and computer-mediated communication. And I want to explain their meanings by using some metrics in order to conclude the subject, in order to objectify the subject. Because I believe that science and art can be side by side in order to understand some subject very well. And many people or many scholars neglected interpersonal communication. Interpersonal communication means can be language in Turkish. Interpersonal communication. Because we have some subconscious sides, dark sides, instincts, meetings, and also conscious sides. Intra-personal communication includes both subconsciousness and also consciousness. We are doing some kind of actions in our life, but we don't have any knowledge about their actions or motives. This is intrapersonal communication. For example, we are sleeping, and when we sleep, we dream, but we are not aware of our dreams. This is intrapersonal communication. But also, but also in my home, for example, before I came here, I studied a lot to prepare my presentation. And when I was studying, I spoke to myself. I spoke to myself. This was interpersonal communication. There was no person around me, but I tried to make a dialogue with myself. Otherwise, it was impossible to prepare myself. So, intrapersonal communication is very strange because I'm trying to make a presentation to you and you are trying to listen to me. But when I look at your eyes, maybe your eyes don't focus on me. Maybe in your brain you can make a journey in another world. I don't have any idea. Maybe Mahmoud is talking to his child. I don't have any idea. This is intrapersonal.
Where do you know?
So we are living, we are sharing the same place with different meanings. We are living in a negative world at the same time. In another world, and at the same time, you are just pretending to listen to me. So, there's another point that I would like to mention. Intrapersonal communication doesn't mean that we are outside the real world. We are connected to real world even though we think something. And maybe this movie clip illustrates my point. This is Greek movie. Its name is Doctor. I should suggest that you watch this movie. And the topic
Can
of this movie.
The name of the movie, please?
Doctor.
Doctor.
Yeah, Doctor. In Turkish, Köpekliş. Doctor.
Oh,
Doctor. The Greek movie, it was made in 2009. The topic of this movie is this. There is a compound, there is a closed area, it is surrounded by the walls, by the fence. The parents, father and mother, tries to raise their children in this closed area from the birth. So the children cannot go away from this area, run away this area. Is prohibited from the parents. So the children are taught a different language. For example, the parents say the table chair, and so they know the meaning of table as a chair. Zombie means in this world, zombie means yellow flower. Yellow flower. So and also there is no television in this world. There is no connection outside. They don't meet other people. They create their own world. But in this world, even their dreams are shaped according to their environment. And this movie clip illustrates this point.
Mother going home to every day, but children.
Mother lives inside the house, but there is the job of the father. He goes outside, he works in the car factory, he's the manager of the factory, and there is only one person who comes to house. This person is a woman. In this movie clip, there is a woman. This movie clip comes to house with blind hope. Okay.
Her
function is to meet the sexual desires of the young man. I mean the father's boy. Just from him. Yeah, she comes here. And there is a dialogue here. And this dialogue
Σε είδα στον ύπνο προχτές. Ήμουν λέει στο δάσος με τον παπά σου βόλτα. Και το βράδυ ανάψαμε φωτιά και ψήσαμε πατάτες για να φάμε. Ξαφνικά ακούστηκε ένας περίεργος ήχος πίσω από τον εαυτό μου. Κι ήσουν εσύ. Κι ήσουν ζόμπι. Και ο μπάς σου πέταγε πέτρες. Κι εγώ. Αλλά δεν μπορούσαμε να σε πετύχουμε τίποτα.
Εγώ τι ήμουνα?
Ζόμπι. Ξέρεις τι είναι τα ζόμπι?
Ξέρω.
Εσύ βλέπεις όνειρα?
Ναι.
Πες μου ένα που είδες τελευταία.
Είδα ότι έπεσε στην πισίνα η μαμά.
Και μετά?
Τίποτα αυτό.
There are differences between their dreams. As you see, the woman's dreams, the woman's dreams are very detailed. Because the woman are dreaming outside and she's meeting with other people, she's connected to the ego. But the man's dream is very simple. Very simple. What was his dream? His dream was about her mother falling down swimming pool. Because there is a swimming pool in the garden, and her dream was shaped according to the environment. There is no detail, there is no... So, I wanted to give this example, because intrapersonal communication doesn't mean that we are connected to the inward. We are not far away from the inward, even though we dream the day. So the woman asks him, do you know zombie? He says the answer is yes, but actually there are differences between the zombie conception. According to the man, zombie means yellow lung, not dead people. So, and in terms of intrapersonal communication, there are two terms. One of them is spontaneity, the other is actualization, self-actualization. Because in the case of intrapersonal communication, spontaneity is the basic feature of intrapersonal communication. Imagine that we are lying down on the beach. There is a sun, and there are some people, children, and they are playing, and we are reading a book, and we are just being ourselves. There is no mandatory thing. There is no obligation. There is no obligation. This is spontaneity. But remember that when we were children, when we were a child, we were picking up stones and we were throwing stones. There is no mandatory feeling. We just want to do this action. This is spontaneity. In the movies, we can see lots of scenes about this spontaneity. And self-actualization means that we want to express ourselves by developing some ways. But there are degrees between self-actualization. Van Gogh painted. Mozart composed music. This is self-actualization. They wanted to make a dialogue with their products. Van Gogh made a dialogue with his paintings. It is high level of self-actualization. High level of self-actualization. And also Mozart. But on the other hand, even ordinary people, even children, self-actualize themselves. How? By throwing stones, for example. By doing simple things, by doing, you know, parallel, by drawing something. So, this is intrapersonal communication example. And there is a philosopher, his name is Eric Fromm. Eric Fromm also was a psychoanalyst and also a philosopher, and according to him, spontaneity can be realized particularly by these three categories. Children, philosophers, and also artists. These categories are very important in order to do some actions in spontaneity. And as you see, there is no obligation, there is no mandatory thing. Children act according to their motives, and everybody can act according to their motives. And there is another example which illustrates this point. The same movie, not the same movie, it is very short. But its meaning very deep.
Ali Muslimandr.
To give a message to the world. What is the message? I am going living in the world, in this closed area, and I want to be free, and it is why I am doing this action. He wants to express himself. This is spontaneity, this is self-actualization for this person. And as you see in the beginning of the movie clip, the woman, the mother, says that he is doing again. It means that every day, maybe many times, he is doing this kind of action. As you see, interpersonal communication is the basic step of communication. And there is another point about the interpersonal communication. Even among the crowd, for example, in the press conference, we can find a chance to lift ourselves from the press conference and create our world. There is a movie about this issue, Nine. In the movie clip, you can see Daniel Day-Lewis. Daniel Day-Lewis acted in the Lincoln as well. He is very talented actor. And in this movie, Guido, in this movie, he is trying to find out his inspiration because he lost inspiration sources. He is movie director, but for the past few years, he cannot make a movie, and he is bored with the real life. He doesn't like many people. He is trying to search his creation power, and at this moment he is putting a press conference, and you can see his mood, his psychological inspiration in this movie clip.
Guess what? The dog is working with you.
But why are you being so tight-lipped about this film? It's a serious question. What's the big deal?
I would like to be here. You want me to be serious in a press conference? I would like to be there. I thought I was the clown in this. I would like to be
everywhere at once. I know that's a
contradiction in terms.
Signor Fontini, artists do their best work before they're famous. Now you're famous. Without wishing to be negative, but your last two films, they're not, they were...
Flops?
Your word, flops.
And it's but a problem. Especially when my body's nearing 50, yet my mind is nearing 10.
I'm just asking if you're nervous. You seem nervous.
Excuse me?
What I'm asking, maestro, is have you run out of things to say?
You recently...
I can hardly stay up. And I can't get to sleep. And I don't want to wake tomorrow morning at the bottom of some heap. But why take it so seriously? After all, there's nothing at stake here, only me. I want to be young. I want to be old. I would like to be wise before my time and yet be foolish and brash and bold. I would like the universe to get down on its knees and say, Guido, whatever you please, it's okay, but if it's impossible, we'll arrange it. That's what I want.
I was wondering if you think there's a limit to what you can show in a movie.
Yes.
Is this a musical movie?
Musical, not a musical movie. But actually, the movie was based upon the novel. And Ozturk-Film made a movie, 8.5. It is a continuation of the movie, maybe. It is a reproduction, I don't have any idea. But Ozturk-Film was one of the best directors, I believe, in the world. Italian directors. So, as you see, the man wants to be young, wants to be old, but he doesn't want to be dead, okay? And he is bored with the question of the journalist, and he is creating his own world. But this world is connected to the real world. Otherwise, he cannot daydream. This is daydream. Daydream means intrapersonal communication. And the last point that I would like to mention about intrapersonal communication, intrapersonal communication, we don't make an effort emotional power, emotional labor. I believe that there are two kinds of labor. One kind of labor is physical labor, and the other kind of labor, emotional labor, duygusal iş gücü. Physical labor is very simple. You know, you are making an effort to produce something. You are working in the factory. You are using your organs, physical body. But on the other hand, we are going to bank. For example, we are seeing many officials, and they are smiling to us. So at this point, we have to ask this question: are they smiling? Smiling is a natural feeling. Natural feeling. There is no obligation indicates in terms of smiling. But they have to smile. They have to smile. Why? Otherwise, they can get fired. So they are not really, they are not genuine smiling. They are not smiling. They are just trying to smile because of the mandatory.
Doing their jobs. They are doing their jobs.
Yeah.
Smiling is
yeah. So then we are coming here. We get on the plane, and there were many flight attendants, and they were smiling. Are they smiling? Were they smiling? So, this is a popular movie. As you see,
yeah.
They are smiling. And the second. So, they are smiling. This is face-to-face communication. In terms of face-to-face communication, we have to smile. But in terms of interpersonal communication, we don't need to be smart. We can insult. We can yell out. We can do whatever we want to do. This is very important for the interpersonal communication. And I just want to be a test. Face-to-face communication. Face-to-face communication, many people think that face-to-face communication is one of the best communication, one of the most important communication. It is superior communication. What we want to do is to interact with others at the same place, at the same time. Yes, generally it is correct. We are now in a position which is related to face-to-face communication. I can hear, I can smell, I can touch, I can use my five senses. Okay, it is correct. But look at this picture. What can you see?
Smiling and hugging.
There are two people. They are wearing. They are wearing suit. Okay, formal suit, and they are shaking. And their eyes contact is very suitable. They are looking at their eyes. But what are their aims? Are they friends? Or are they trying to make a deal? Are they trying to do business?
And trying to.
Yeah, maybe they are putting on their masks. I don't have so much time, but I want to be hurried. There are two values. One value is intrinsic value. İçkin değer, intrinsic value, the other value, instrumental value, araçsal değer. So, are you here? You want to listen to me. Why do you want to listen to me? Because I want to improve myself. Why do you want to improve yourself? Because I want to improve my spoken English. Why do you want to improve your spoken English? Because I want to be big man, for example. But the final point is to be happy. I want to be happy.